throughout the evening and overnight. And right now, I just have a 20% chance for an isolated shower for your Monday. So some good news there. Now, as we take a look at the radar, here's the big picture. You can see where all that heavy rain is located. It is still moving over parts of southern Mississippi, southern Alabama, and towards the Florida panhandle. So remember, we just saw all the video of that flooding weather that was into that part of the country. Well, it looks like more heavy rain continuing to move that direction. But we like the direction that it's moving as far as our weather goes, because it's moving away from us, pushing off to the east and northeast. And as we look off to the west, we're not seeing much at all. So I do expect the rain chances to be very small for the rest of tonight once we get rid of this batch of moisture that's located in the southern half of the viewing area, especially into Plaquemines Parish. You can see we're seeing some of that heavy rain. And the further north you go, just an isolated shower setting up. Now, earlier today, we had a training setup. We called training thunderstorm setup. And you can see we had thunderstorms moving over the same area for an extended period of time. And whenever you get that, that's when you have to worry about the flooding potential. We had reports of flooding, especially out towards Metairie and River Ridge. There was some heavy rain that we got some reports of some flooded roadways into that part of the viewing area. So we had to deal with that today, but I do expect the flooding conditions to decrease as we make our way over the next couple of hours so we can get some relief from that heavy rain. Notice the satellite imagery, though. Lots of cloud cover out there, seeing the clearing off to the west, but I think we'll be mostly cloudy for the rest of tonight. You can see that expansive cloud cover continuing to push over southeastern Louisiana and southern Mississippi. Now, this is a look at our forecast models, doing a good job of picking up on the thunderstorms, but I think they're a little too far west. They should be a little bit further off to the east, but it does also a good job of showing these showers and storms pushing out of the area. Then notice what happens tomorrow morning. We'll see a few clouds. I wouldn't be surprised, especially off to the west, maybe a few areas of patchy fog. So maybe if you commute from New Orleans and you head to Baton Rouge, you might deal with some foggy conditions tomorrow morning, but we don't have to worry about any rain chances to start the day. And then for the afternoon, this is at 5 o'clock, you can see just that isolated shower chance, nothing severe, and no flood watches or flood warnings to worry about for tomorrow. So some great news there. Now, one thing, yes, we've been dealing with the heavy rain, but the good news, when we get all this heavy rain, it helps out with the temperatures. Look how good it feels out there. Well below average this afternoon. It's 77 in the city, 77 in Belle Chasse. Houma, you're at 79 degrees, 75 at the lakefront. And as we take a look at our temperature forecast, I don't see it really fluctuating too much for the rest of tonight and early tomorrow morning. But tomorrow afternoon, I think we're going to stay into the middle and upper 80s. And then as we push into the afternoon time, we could see temperatures close to the upper 80s, maybe even near 90 degrees. Now, we did have some heavy rainfall today, anywhere from 1 to 3 inches all across the viewing area. Some areas had stronger amounts than that. Slidell reports of over 3 inches of rainfall for you. Other areas, though, did see a good amount of rainfall, anywhere from 1 to 3 inches. Now, there's a look at your detailed 7-day exactcast. I have just the 20% chance for storms tomorrow, but the storm chances, they rise again. By the middle part of the work week, we're watching another disturbance off to our north. That could send some active weather this way, and those storm chances might continue.